my sun-baked friend. Any luck in old Lady Surrey's tour, Bing? Feeling your advancing age, are you? Well, no matter. I don't mind repeating myself if I must. I'll even use Lang. Find the tomb where Joanna Surrey is buried. Retrieve the mysterious heirloom that was buried with her. Bring it to me.
Tarquin sighed.
I hate to sound so condescending, but sometimes it pays to be straightforward. I'm sure you enjoy yourself in the crypts, for the both of us.
Curse those masked freaks.
Ah, my sun-baked friend. Any luck in old ladies?
Try as he might, Tarquin cannot hide a small flash of surprise.
Where did you hear that precisely? Never mind. The Aetirin is a children's fable, nothing more. Supposedly a wand, really? Well, perhaps that says more about the caliber of their intellect than anything else. Such a device would be a gross overconcentration of power. It could purge the entire world of all sorts. Luckily, the laws of the universe render such a thing impossible. Well, huh. That's a relief. Not the most accommodating sorcerer I've known. Still, I'd sooner toil outside the gates than in. His aura... Oh, goodness. The disappointment to take a few deep breaths. Lovely day. Perfect weather for it.
This grave marker is old. Whatever name was once carved upon it is no longer legible.
All these bones.
I found something.
Still stuck. There must be another one.
What's this? I found something.
Won't budge. How inconvenient. It's locked. Maybe it's connected to some other mechanism. It's locked fast. Maybe it's connected to some other mechanism. Maybe it's connected to some other mechanism. Won't budge. How inconvenient. What did that do? It's not really what I had in mind. What did that do? What did that do? Not the outcome I'd hoped for. All this wealth's just been going to waste.
Unlike so many other spirits, this one is hardly silent. She clicks and squawks the moment you approach her, like a cornered crow facing down a hungry owl.
Are you the new servant then? My, my. You look like my old handbag but dipped in cherry wine. You brought my tea, have you?
The spirit takes the invisible cup from you and takes a sip of non-existent liquid.
I've tasted better brews, but from the look of you, the refreshments won't be improving.
She waits a moment.
You expecting a tip? Well, here's one. Exfoliate. That old thing, it was passed to me by my father, Johannes. And my father's father, Johannes. And my father's 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 father, Johannes. Don't know what happened to the one in the middle. Don't rightfully know what it's supposed to do. Johannes, the umpteens, brought it back from Blood Moon Island. I thought it might be good for stirring stew, but the cook gave it back. Said it made her feel funny. Whatever that...
The spirit stands there smiling, as if she hadn't just uttered the words of demons. Luckily, you understood them. Anathema seeks blood.
What just happened? You mean my display of proper posture and etiquette? The benefits of charm school, I don't expect you'd qualify. Hurry back. The eyebrows still need plucking.
You feel the unusual object's vast energy before your hand even touches its smooth surface. Upon contact, the semi-transparent artifact shivers and speaks. And like the artifact you found on Blood Moon Island, this one intones the tongue of demons.
When as one, I am slayer of sin and the bane of the living. Restore my twin. Make me whole. In archive of old, the blade resides, an isle of blood.
The oblong object is crystal clear and unmarked by marks or chips, much like the blade you recovered on Blood Moon Island. They are clearly two parts of the same whole. The object repeats its cryptic remarks. The object speaks once more, and you consider your fortune in understanding its demonic...
I'm demon true, taken to Isle of Vaults. Exorcised from host most dear. The priest Anathema, I'm called, but only half's before you. In archives rest the blame. The path is marked.
The heirloom is silent once more.
We're trapped.
not trying to escape, are you?
Dead. Well, more dead.
Thank you. want that idea. We might have to fight him for it.
This thing speaks to me, but what is it trying to say?
Wild guess here, but I'll wager this relic will turn out useful for killing, somehow.
Doesn't make any sense. I don't want to find out if that's a warning or an invitation.
My tongue! It's speaking the language of the Eternals. I mean, it is gibberish, but such beautifully phrased gibberish.
Sounds like any other plea for mercy to me. Utter nonsense.
It has a nice rhythm to it, doesn't it? Kind of like a song. Beautiful.
My sun-baked friend. Any luck in old lady Surrey's?
He places his hand on the artifact, and it drones in the demonic tongue. When, as one, I am slayer of sin and the bane of the living, restore my twin, make me hot. The object continues. In archive of old, the blade resides. An isle of blood where deep.
It's true, then. Anathema. Within reach. Tell me, is this all there was? There weren't any other curios in there? Amazing, but not unexpected.
He breathes a long, lugubrious sigh.
It's time I leveled with you. This is the hand grip of the fabled anathema. A sword capable... Imagine it. Holding in your hand a force that could wipe away sun and shadow. A sword of life and death, miracle and sin. A sword of... I can restore anathema to working condition. But this is only half of it. We still need the blade. How fortunate that the hilt has already told.
The object quivers as Tarquin nears it and hums a response. Connected as one, the past and present slain.
Oh, very good. This, my friend, is the key. Give me some time, and every day.
He holds out his hand expectantly.
Lovely. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must work.
Tarquin turns away, but continues to mutter excitedly, almost religiously, about anathema.
Let me think, a sprinkling of skull dust, a vial of dog's drool, dried illweed, a few more odds and ends, and I can get back to the ship.
The winged stone figure reaches to the heavens. You feel weightless, as if lifted.
Shame I had to leave the stone garden behind. I feel so at home among the graves.
Speak to me if you're looking for hired help. I've got good fighters of every... Oh, I see you have a full contingent already. Then I'll leave you be.
So? Ready to set sail when you are, Your Holiness. Fantastic. Now, on to the interesting part.
After many adventures, the party finally reached the place where Godwo can go to become divine. But more surprises and difficult choices awaited.
The Nameless Isle. And here I thought Malady was unimaginative. Still, it's what's on the inside that counts, isn't that right? And this is the place you're meant to become a god. I can't help but wonder exactly what you intend to do with such a power. I have no doubt about that, but do remember, you can do what's good for you, too. All things in balance. You'll want to hurry now. Divinity is waiting, after all. Excellent question. Normally, this place ought only to be known to Godwoken, but judging by the ships burning in the bay, there's been a breach. Regardless of who's on the island, all that matters is who ascends. Make sure that's you. The strongest will survive and ascend. I'm hardly an expert on the matter, but I'm smart enough to put two and two together. Where there is an ocean of source, there is a well for draw. To rise to divinity, you probably need to take a gulp. Though I'm sure it won't be that simple.
Sibille scours the horizon wistfully, tension apparent in her features.
The Master, he's on the island. I'm closer to... He can still control me with the Scar Song. There is but one way to circumvent his command. I must teach someone else the song so that they may counter the master when the time comes. But such a thing requires the utmost...
She looks you squarely in the eyes.
Not just yet.
Okay, wait. Before we go any further, there's something I want to ask you.
course it can't wait. Okay, so did you hear the one about the pregnant lich? She forgot her prophylactery. You're very generous, thank you. I just want to lighten the mood, the smallest of scooches. I mean, we're at the Nameless Isle. One of us, I guess things are about to get, interesting. Same to you, Chief. Same to you. And when push comes to...
Look at that island, Quercus. Covered in forest.
Can you smell it?
Over the stink of the water. Millennia of mull. We are better to find a clue about the great... The Knights of Dre will never find us here. There's no rest for the wicked, Quercus. Somewhere on this ancient isle, there must be a... We must tread carefully. What would we do, Quercus? Why, anyway, we have something for your new...
The squirrel reaches out and hands you a piece of bark, covered in tiny, scratched...
Something I discovered in your lizard friend's basement. She won't miss it, but use it well.